This is Bonds off Broadway in Vancouver. This is the men's washroom. I can't get far enough back to take it all in. That's the door. Sink, the mirror. You can't even see yourself in the mirror. The toilet's the only thing that's not written on. Or the urinal. I imagine the toilet's just, yeah. The whole restaurant is like this. Oh, what do you know? My friend Chuck just came back.
What's up, Chuck?
What's up, Chuck? And life of Chuck.
Just came from the washroom. The first sign I seen was gangster rape. Not a good thing to see when you're walking into the washroom.
What did you think of the men's washroom?
Interesting.
Just like here, eh?
Did you video it?
Yeah.
I was thinking of videoing it too. So.
And he's got two.
I have freedom.
He's
I have
got two.
Freedom to do as I want. The same. If you own a, or even if you own a house, you still have no freedom because you're told you got to mow your lawn. Like in Winnipeg, you're fined if your lawn grows
right.
up. Or you got to cut the boulevard. Or you can't build this in your backyard.
Lots of restrictions,
shed.
Yeah.
So you're still restricted.
I'm going to ask you that same question.
Yeah.
I want your opinion there, Chuck. Is if you won $1 million tomorrow, $1 million,
$1 million,
you can ask me the same question. I don't have to put it on my video, and I'll let you video it. But what would you, because I want your opinion. What would you do if you won $1 million tomorrow?
Well, you stole my answer before.
You answered the way you think.
You know what? I wouldn't change it because I like the freedom and I kind of like the adventure. I would buy what I showed you in the picture, an older 70s, probably Dodge, or even older yet, and I would renovate it to what I want
right.
to look like on the inside.
I don't think you stole my answer, because I think people in our situation,
yeah.
I think the answer is going to be the same. You know that? A lot of people are going to have that answer.
I think a high percentage would.
Because they know the lifestyle. And yes, $1 million would come in handy. You could do what you wanted.
In all honesty, $1 million is nothing.
Yes.
Comparative
today,
to Vancouver. Sorry about touching your leg.
Today, $1 million.
Under the table, things that are going on under the table that they don't see.
No, you're right. $1 million is not really a hell of a lot of money today.
You can't even buy your house in Vancouver. But you know what? It would buy freedom, again, to build out a unit that I wanted. And I like the idea of staying anywhere.
Right.
I don't want to be stuck in one place. I like that adventure. I can go to Squamish this weekend or today. I just pick up and do anything and go anywhere. Oh, you know what? I'm having an event in Washington. We're having a meeting. You know what? I can get up and go.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah. And aspect. Then like we were talking about the restrictions. You buy a house, you now are restricted to a lot
still
of things.
Restricted.
Your view every morning when you get up is the same.
Yeah.
It never changes. You can't just turn the key on and go somewhere.
Yeah. No, I like that idea of freedom, mobile living. I like cars, vehicles.
Yeah.
So, and I like driving. Some people, they don't want to, oh, you know what? I want to be stuck here in this area, this parking lot. I don't want to go anywhere. I'm the opposite. It's like, I want to go and explore.
Exactly.
So,
exactly. Yeah. I don't want to be one of those guys that are parked on the street and you stay there and people are noticing you and you got your plants and stuff outside your door.
No. I want to know that I can turn the key on and in 30 seconds.
Gone. Yeah.
I can go across the city and see something else.
Yeah.
Honestly,
fantastic.
If I won $1 million, I might consider temporary housing, like staying overseas for 6 months or 3 months.
Yeah.
But I would still keep a
But then,
van
like
or,
you said,
yeah.
I don't know if $1 million would buy you a house in Vancouver.
No.
And if you did, if you could afford to buy a house, I'd probably rent it out.
Well, yeah, you make a lot of money Airbnb it here.
Yeah.
But I would go, like, you know, Mexico, rent a place for $500 a month for a couple of weeks. I wouldn't need the fancy pool, this and that. I'd want to stay with the locals and learn about their culture and what they do.
That's well. Thank you, Chuck, for the interview. I'm going to cut it short here and probably a long one, but it's a good one. It's a good interview. So, okay, guys, here's Life of Chuck's YouTube channel, and this is how easy it is, guys. You go to the subscribe right here. It's usually in red if you haven't already subscribed. So you click on that and subscribe, and then there's a little bell right beside. You click on the bell and then pick the all option, and you'll be subscribed to Life of Chuck and his awesome channel with all of his really good content I like. He lives in Vancouver, but he tours all over the city, taking you along and where he goes. And he tours all over the Vancouver area, Vancouver Island, all the small islands around, Gibson's, Sunshine Coast, all over the place. He travels with his girlfriend, and sometimes by himself, but he travels with his girlfriend, and they travel all over the place here, going to different places and showing you where they sleep, where they spend the day, places that you can go and visit and tour. So I encourage all of you. You can see he's got 800 subscribers right here. So let's get him up to at least 825, guys. Go to his channel. Like I said, click on the subscribe if you haven't done so already. And then click on the little bell. That's how easy it is. It doesn't cost you a penny to do that. And you'll find that Chuck has a great channel. You'll enjoy it. And I'm sure I can get his followers, his subscribers, built up a little bit. So let's try to get him up to at least 825 here in the next few days, guys. That's simple.